Rolling Stone, what's up? I'm Freddie Lomeli. Welcome to the green room with Mochakk. Bro, I have been wanting to meet you now for quite some time.
Bro, nice
you
to
are
meet
one
you.
Of these musicians, not only a globe-trotting superstar DJ from Brazil, but really just an all-around great guy. So first of all, bienvenido a Miami.
Oh, muchas gracias, hermano. Vamos.
Have you been here before?
Yes, I've been here a couple of times, yes.
I mean, Miami loves this style of music. Miami goes crazy. Miami does not sleep during Music Week. And we're gonna take advantage of that right now to talk about your experience.
They think of it as a marathon, like it should be. It's not a race, it's a marathon, Music Week. Let's go, guys.
Now, we have a couple of hours before you go on here at Factory Town in the wonderful town of Hialeah here in Miami. So what do you do right before you know you have a killer show like tonight?
Digging, definitely.
Digging for what?
Digging for music to play.
So it's something that you sort of, as a true artist, does improvise it sometimes on the spot. You get to a city, do you feel out the vibe, and then do you create the set list, or what's
usually,
your process?
Yeah, usually I will have like a couple of moments. Like for example, while I'm digging for stuff to play, I might come across like two tracks that sound really good together. Like when I'm listening to the stuff that I'm gonna bring, I'm like, oh, this sounds good together. Maybe I'll play these two, one after the other in the set tonight. But the time that's gonna happen, it's totally random, because on the spot, you're gonna just look at the people and be like, oh, another way. Let's go this way, let's go that way. Oh, people are like, oh, now.
Yeah.
Let me, don't make them boom for too long. Like, otherwise they're gonna get tired. Let me go down a bit. Gotta do like a roller coaster.
So you kind of feel to me, and this is the beautiful thing about music that I always love and that I'm sure you appreciate, because you take from many different types of styles. So the way you're speaking with me right now about sort of working the crowd is the way a conductor sort of shapes the orchestra to his music, right?
That's so a DJ.
That's exactly what a DJ does. Tell us about your upbringing in Brazil, because I hear you love 80s music. I hear you were inspired by so many different genres.
From a really young age, my parents were music lovers, both of them. My mom was more into the 80s side of things. She liked like new wave, like Europop, stuff like that from that era. And my dad was more of a rock guy. But he also loved blues, he liked jazz, he liked classical music, he had like a big collection of classical music, CDs and stuff. So they always showed me music from a very young age, and I started having like the will to play instruments really young.
And you just started recreating it, I was reading, right?
Yeah, when I got to like, when I was 12 or something, I downloaded Fruity Loops at my mom's computer, and I just tried to recreate like beats
and
that I like.
The rest is history, brother. So what was their reaction when you gave them? I feel like there's a lot of things that you tell your parents in life that might be like big moments, and then it's like, mom, dad, I want to be a DJ. You know what I mean?
It's kind of
what was their reaction at first when you told them that?
It's a little bit awkward, you know, like, cause I was already doing college when I decided to switch things and just like, all right, full-time DJ, that's it now. I was at fashion school at the time, and that was already a little bit awkward to begin with. Not to my mom, because my mom was a fashion designer herself, but my dad's an economist.
Okay.
I was like, yo, dad, fashion college. I was like, all right, do you think? And then, middle of fashion college is happening. I'm like, starting to play gigs and stuff. It was just a hobby before.
Yeah.
I always loved showing music to people, and I've been always like really extroverted and really easy, like to make, like I made friends really easy, talked to the people really, really easily. I was never really shy, like for that type of stuff. And I always liked to show music to people, like on my phone, like, yo, listen to this. Yeah. I found this to like this week.
They say that
this
a good
is crazy.
Friend is the one that always introduces you to good new music.
Definitely.
Right? Absolutely.
And I went to, when I was a little bit younger, I was on dance classes for a while. I used to dance hip hop and break dancing.
Break dancing.
Yeah. And while I had like that moment of my life, that period of my life, I got in contact with battles. And in battles, like 1v1 battles of dance, you have a DJ playing tunes, random tunes. You have to pick it up on the go and do your moves to that music that you never heard. So I was really like developing an ear for hearing and showing visually.
And just connecting to it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So when I was gonna show you a song in my phone now, I would be like, yo, listen to this part. Boop, 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 boop. Like I would do gestures to show you like the song.
Yeah.
And it was just something that came naturally and without me performing. And it, when I started to perform, it just naturally became part of it.
What was your favorite breakdance move of all time? We can switch gears real quick.
Bro, the chair grab is really fire. I was never really good at doing it, but it's like you have to put your hand really in the back here, like in this bone area.
Yeah,
right here.
No.
And you hold your leg like this.
And did you ever master
like a chair? Nah, my arms were really never that flexible to reach my back, but I just loved seeing it.
So tell us a little bit about the stages that you've been around the world. We mentioned you are one of like literally your description on Apple Music, for example, is globe-trotting superstar Brazilian DJ, because you're everywhere, bro. What is it like for you to travel from country to country, expressing your art? And is there a difference between performing at Coachella and performing at Factory Town in Miami?
Definitely. Wow. It's a lot of
it's
stuff.
It's a lot.
Let's go.
It's a lot.
So, how does it feel to travel across
all
the
over
world?
The world?
It feels really amazing. It's something that I always love to do, travel and discover new things, new cultures, yeah. New food, whatever. So being able to travel all around the world with my job, with the stuff that I love, is obviously an amazing opportunity. It's really, really beautiful. But there's also the side of it of being away from home.
Yeah.
At a young age, like I have my friends, I have my family, I have my little brother, like growing up. So having to deal with the tug of war of doing it, traveling to the most places you can, just like seeing all these beautiful things and playing a lot of different music for different people and all that good stuff. But also like trying to make it in a sustainable way so I don't like, so I spend the time that I need with loved ones and everything.
You mentioned sustainable, and that's something that also I feel sets you apart as an artist, is that you mention it in a family sense, but I know you could also be considered a humanitarian in many other ways. Tell us about Tropicalia, if I'm pronouncing it correctly. I love
Tropicalia.
Tropicalia. Yeah. I love the idea of Brazil considering themselves a sponge with other cultures, other sounds, other art forms, and using it to be their strength. How did you get involved with this philosophy?
So, Tropicalia happened in the midst of the military dictatorship in Brazil back in the day, and censorship was booming. And a lot of the movement was also trying to say the stuff that they thought they needed to say about what was happening.
Right.
But they couldn't say it because of the censorship. So they would hide the stuff in the lyrics and also like make sure the message was sent, but trying to like
absolutely
keep it on the low. So they wouldn't be exiled out.
So that the people that could absorb the art could absorb the message as well, and
people
it could spread.
Like, oh, I get what he's saying. He's not talking about this. Oh, wow. And like, I think art pays that role a bit in society. It's always been the voice of the people for a lot of occasions. Like through art, a lot of things that were kind of taboo-ish have been said, and a lot of change has come from the spark of that. Like sometimes you spark someone, you're like with what you did, that person sparks a movement.
What does it mean to you that we're starting to see a little bit more of censorship attempts? Not that they're being successful all the time, but there are some censorship attempts with certain types of music, certain types of books. What do you say to the people who maybe don't see it as a big deal?
It is a big deal, definitely, because like if you want to get a message spread to a lot of people, if you want to get something spread to a lot of people, if you have blockage on your vehicles, that's really, really difficult. But I think like what we can encourage people is, if you think of the military dictatorship, kind of try to go independent if you're not being able, because also a lot of ways stuff works in the industry, all across industries around the world, have already like a blockage system on the vehicle just because of the system itself.
Yeah.
So trying to go independent sometimes, like with some of the stuff you do, for example, if this vehicle, the system is not letting me use this vehicle is being used by other people, let me try to gather a bunch of people that have the same, like, that are in the same situation as me and try to create our own way to make our message reach other places.
Tropicalia did that for you. And what are you gonna do for us here in Miami? I know that I asked you the question earlier, what's your mentality? How does it differentiate between going into Coachella and coming to Miami?
Perfect.
So let's go back to that.
I think Music Week Miami, Factory Town here, this has more of a, I know it's a festival, but from the sound of Miami, I think it has a clubby vibe. It has like that energy, that intimacy a bit.
Yeah.
And when it's a festival, like a big festival like Coachella, not only you have multiple styles of music playing a role in what you're gonna play,
right? You have to be a little bit more general market in Coachella, perhaps.
Kind of. I think it's more towards the mindset of, I have to figure out a way to show the people that are listening to indie band right here, rock band right here, R&B band right here,
right,
how they can come into my universe and discover my music.
Yeah.
Because a lot of artists that I like that I discovered at festivals, I just happened to be there in that stage,
yeah,
when they were playing and be like, oh, this intrigued me.
Right.
So how can I intrigue people when it's a festival like Coachella? How can I bring a bit of indie rock, a bit of that into the house music that I'm playing, into what I'm playing right here, to lure them in, you know,
yeah,
to what I'm gonna show them that's new? Because like, it's that mix match. It's like, give them something, pull them in,
yeah,
give them healthy food.
And the fact that you're going on at 3 a.m. for music, Miami Music Week, how do you immediately capture the crowd's attention? Do you have already an idea of what you're gonna start with tonight?
Imagine that I wanna play Deftones type of thing,
yeah,
in the beginning of the set. And somebody's playing like classic rock before me.
Yeah.
I have to play track 1 that's more similar to classic rock, track 2 that's a little bit more left field, track 3 that's kind of a mix between Deftones and classic rock, track 4 it's more towards this side, then I get to Deftones.
And then you get
so
to
that's
that.
Also like the way that I think about when I'm coming in at 3 a.m. I have to listen to what's playing before,
right,
to know what I'm gonna play first. To know where I'm gonna go afterwards. Like, I have to come here a little bit earlier, listen a bit, dance a bit,
yeah,
see how stuff is happening, look at how the people are reacting to the music and to themselves, and just figure out how to start banging it.
Your vibes are absolutely contagious. What advice do you have for artists who are maybe starting out, who wanna go your route, but perhaps feel overwhelmed in the oversaturation of social media and 10 million songs being released every day and whatnot? Don't quote me on those numbers, but it's somewhere ridiculously high like that.
Uh-huh. I think an advice would be, try to diverse your diet of your intake of stuff. Like, get it more diverse. Like, because if you only try to base your music and your social media and what you're doing, for example, in one direction, like if I want to go this route with the music, I'm gonna listen to this, figure out this, and just go this way. You're kind of gonna be a stripped down version of that. Because
yeah,
those people that you're looking up to, they probably looked at a lot of different stuff to create their musical identity and then become themselves. If you're doing the same thing with your social media stuff, if I'm like, all right, I figured it out. It's this type of content, so it's this type of video.
With this aesthetic.
This aesthetic and this blah, blah, blah. And you know, you're gonna do generic content.
Yeah.
But if you like watch documentaries, watch like, I don't know, skate movies, you watch like
porn films,
movies, like drama movies and comedy movies and skits and blah, blah, blah. If you have a big intake of different stuff that you consume in the media side of things, you can also have way more ideas that are related to those. Maybe it's grabbing something from this with something from this, and I have an idea of content that I can make for
because
social
media. The way it has to be, whether social media or music, nobody's gonna reinvent the wheel, so you have to just be influenced as originally as possible. So when it comes
and
to being—
And show your influences in a humble way.
So what are you gonna show us with your upcoming EP? I know you're excited for it. I wasn't gonna leave without talking about it, and this is our last question. Tell us what we can expect. People have been waiting for it for a long time. I'm sure you have as well.
I'm gonna bring like diverse again as a word, because I feel like it's a very diverse EP in the sense of music that's in it. Like, there is club music, like straight up club banging music. There is songs, like songs for you to do your
jam
coffee
out
and
to
take a shower, singing it, just, you know? There are trippy, very like progressive music for the floor also, but also for traveling around and blah, blah, blah. It's a very multi-faced EP. So I think it has the potential to show my universe to the people, like my head.
We can't wait to get inside that universe as well. Mochakk, man, you're amazing. Thank you, brother, for letting us step inside your green room as you prepare for a couple of big shows here at Miami Music Week. And also you have an incredible show in June, I know, in New York City, Mochakk Calling, which is already completely sold out.
It is.
You're taking over the world. We're gonna follow you every step of the way, bro.
Thank you so much.
Thank you guys for hopping into the green room.